Hello again, everyone. This is Tom from EveryStepCalculus.com, EveryStepPhysics.com. I'm going to do partial derivatives now in this video. And generally, it's with respect to calculus 2 or 3. Let's do it. Index 8 to get to my menu. And we're going to scroll up to get to the P's quicker. Goes to the bottom of the alphabet so we can get to what we're looking for is partial derivatives in the menu. You can go second on the titanium second and then these cursors to go page by page. Do that here to get through the menu quicker. And we're looking at, let's see, partial fractions. Here's partial derivatives. And I program first order or second order. I'm going to do first order in this problem. Z equals f to the x to the y. We're going to enter our function. The function given is you have to press alpha before you enter anything into these entry lines in my programs, okay? So alpha, and then we're going to press gold, the T here, which gives us the arctangent for y divided by x. I always show you what you've entered so you can change it if you've made a mistake. Say it's okay. And here's the partial derivatives with respect to x is minus y divided by x squared plus y squared. This is a, if you go to my trig identities, you'll see that tangent to the minus 1 is 1 over the quantity 1 plus x squared. In this case, it would be 1 over the quantity 1 plus y divided by x squared to get the derivative of with respect to x. And with respect to y, it's this equation here. And then there's a point A and B that they give you. I'm going to press the one for A is alpha minus 2. Make sure you don't interchange the minus sign for the negative sign. And then for the B, we're going to get alpha 7 is given. Again, I show you what you've entered. We say that's okay. And so the problem asks for f of x, a and b, which is this right here. You're replacing the y's and the x's for whatever is given here for a and b. And I have to use quotation marks the way the calculator is allows me to with programming, but you're going to use parentheses here. Anytime you see quotation, you're because you're substituting x and y values for the x and y values in the function. And the answer is minus 7 over 53. Now, if they asked you for f of y, you'd go one step further. And that would be substituting this, and you get minus 2 over 53. Pretty neat, huh? EveryStepCalculus.com. Go to my site, subscribe to me so you can see other videos if you're interested. Have a good one.